Leo, and welcome to Positive Light Tarot. My name is Tracy, and I am so happy that you are here with me today. This is your money, career, and finance reading for the month of August. So I will be concentrating on your incoming energies. We're going to do some tarot cards, and I will clarify if need be. We're going to do some career, life, and oracle cards, as well as your fortune and your making magic oracle as well. So we'll get an idea of what's happening for the month of August. Now, this is a general reading, so take what resonates and leave the rest. And if you find that only parts of it resonate, please leave comments. I do love to read them, and they really help me to connect with your energy as well. Now, I've already meditated and prepared the cards for your reading, but I would like to cleanse the space together. So we will do that with the bell. So you will hear a loud bell sound now. All right, Leo. So let's get into your energies. So for those of you that are returning to my channel, welcome back. Thank you so much for all your love and support. And those of you who are new, thank you again. Thank you for tuning in to me today. I appreciate it. So let's get these energies that are surrounding you for the month of August. Let's find out what those energies are. And this is for career, money, and finance for the beautiful sign Leo. We are in Leo season, so happy birthday to all my beautiful Leo. All right, there we go. Oh, that one wants to come out. That one just turned the way that it did for a reason. Okay. All right, so you've got some interesting energies here. Number four, rest and rejuvenate. Okay, maybe it's time. This might be the month where you need to take a little bit of time out for yourself, a little bit of self-love, a little bit, getting a little bit of extra sleep, rejuvenating your energy, making sure that you're staying positive, making sure that you're, you know, tuning into your health, you know, taking that time out to maybe have a more balanced diet, eating better, taking care of yourself. So again, when we can really increase and stabilize our inner resources, of course, it's just going to make everything that much better. You're going to think clearer, you're spiritually going to feel better, and physically you're going to feel healthier. So it's really, you know, you may be coming off of a time where things have been a little anxious and a little bit go, go, go. Well, now it's time to do a little bit of that rest and rejuvenate. Looks as if you're going to be coming to some victories and some successes here with number six, victory and success. You know, you're coming to the edge where I think it's time to really feel that nice balanced energy of victory. So something, again, maybe this is why you're able to take this rest and rejuvenation period, is because you're feeling that you've reached some sort of a success in your life here. So we will find out what that is. Number 15, temptation. This is devil energy. Well, sometimes when we're really basking in the beautiful victory and successes, we can set ourselves off in some directions that we know are a little unhealthy. So it's really important for you to really make sure that you are being mindful of your of you know, the foods that you're eating, you know, the people that you're hanging around. You know, don't indulge too much on things that you know aren't good for you. You know, we don't want to be tempted in directions that bring us down a path that we know is again not a lucrative path. Make sure you are getting that rest and rejuvenation so that you are keeping your mind alert, so that, you know, if there are decisions and choices that are coming up for you, that you're making them with a nice, clear mind. Let's also keep in mind that August 4th is not only the new moon in your sign Leo, which is a great time to manifest all your new beginnings and your new fresh starts, but it's also Mercury retrograde. It's the beginning of that, where, you know, it is time for reflection. There can be delays in travel. There can be delays in communications. We don't always communicate the best way either. Sometimes we jump to conclusions during Mercury retrogrades, but if we look at the positives, it is the time to really sit back, reflect, review. If there's contracts or paperwork that needs to be signed, it's really important for you to really pay attention to the details. Make sure that you're taking everything seriously and that you're not rushing anything. You know, I think there's going to be a lot of victory and success, but I think that you also have to keep in mind that, you know, do not let that victory and success run on for so long that you're in celebration mode for too long. Don't let anything overpower you or take control of you in any way. Don't allow any toxic relationships to, disrupt your rest or that rejuvenation period. Make sure that you are trying to stay at your healthiest during the course of this month for your finances and career. And number 21, universe, that's the world. You know, that's closing out chapters. So I think that there are things. I think if you have been feeling, maybe, you know, coming into this reading, you know, in the past, you've been feeling a little bit like your hands were tied and that you were, you know, kind of, you didn't know how to reach victory or success. Well, I believe that that's all coming to a close with that universe card. And you are actually going to have a very beautiful, restful, successful month. All right, so let's get right into your tarot cards. Let's find a little bit about what's happening as we move through the month of August for Leo. This is for your career, money, and finance. Let's find out. Spirit Angels Guides. We've got one there. We will clarify if need be. There's a couple more. All right. Wow. Look at, we've got success. All right. Let's get all these cards here. So let's start with number 8 of swords. That is fear. Okay. That is your fear. Maybe, you know, again, that could be your fear of feeling trapped, right? Feeling like you're being controlled. I think that you're breaking yourself out of this cycle. I believe that's why the world card is here. And that's why you're feeling a sense of success and victory with this beautiful number 6, victory and success. I think you've been doing a lot of thinking. I think there's been a lot of mental processes going on in your head. And when we overthink things or overanalyze things, we can get to that point with this 8 of swords where it's kind of that uncertainty. It's that feeling trapped. It's feeling like we're trapped in our mind or we're trapped with our thoughts. We don't feel like we can make decisive or clear decisions because it's this sense of making the wrong decision or this sense of fear. But what you have to realize is, Leo, with this card here, these swords are not even touching you. Your hands are loosely tied and this blindfold can come off very easily. It's a choice that you can consciously make. So just know that you have the power and the strength to be able to untie yourself from this, that you always have choice and that you, I think with the way that the cards are coming out here is that there is going to be a lot of victory and success. So if you've been overthinking things, I think you're going to really allow that to, you know, to kind of, you're going to close that cycle out for yourself. And then you got number 7, the Chariot. And that's a beautiful card. That is a victory card in itself as well. It's a Cancer card. You are really guiding your own chariot. You are the one that makes the decisions. Ultimately, you know exactly the path that you want to go on. Intuitively, spiritually, you know. You aren't going to do anything based on fear because you're going to release those fears. You're going to release those fears to the universe. You're going to let them assume all those fears. You're going to allow yourself to rest and you're going to be able to feel much healthier and that's going to bring you to your victory and success. So again, another victory here, you're guiding that chariot. The 2 of Wands is all about movement, plans, choices. You know, it's like you are faced here with some decisions that you're going to make and you're very motivated to take the movement and the steps forward. See, the gate is open here. You have 2 options. You have 2 ways that you can go here. The world really is your oyster. Right now, you're feeling a little blocked because when you open up that gate, all you can see is this tree that's standing there. But the light is shining down on you, okay? And I think with a little bit more information, when you're able to release this fear and this overthinking, you are going to be able to feel like you can freely move to make some decisions. Because again, the world, you're holding the world in the palm of your hand. It's like the world is your oyster. And you know what? That world is limitless right now. There's many things that are there and those opportunities are waiting for you. And then you also got the 4 of Swords, which again is that rest and rejuvenate. So I believe that you really are. This is going to be a month of success and victory for you. You're closing up chapters in your life where you've been feeling uncertainty, fear, and a sense of being controlled. You're standing your ground and you're really starting to recuperate. Mind-wise and body-wise, you know, you are really starting to feel a lot stronger. And again, if you've been having sleepless nights because you've been overthinking situations and, you know, which direction do I go in my life? I want to move, but I'm not sure exactly which way to move. I think you're going to really get that. Those answers are going to be delivered to you this month. It's all leading you to your 10 of coins. And of course, the 10 of coins is that sense of pure abundance, pure prosperity. You know, it's like your treasure chest. You know, you're waiting for that treasure island. And this is your treasure island. You are working towards a long-term success here. And again, I think you're going to reach it. I think that you're going to feel a sense of completion, you know, towards the end of the month. I think a lot of answers are going to come to you. And I think it's because you're allowing yourself to naturally heal as well. You're giving yourself the time to recuperate. Again, if your energy has been sort of fragmented, your energy has been fragmented in so many different ways because you've been trying to figure out solutions, this is going to be the month where you're going to be able to make those plans. You're going to maybe be able to make those choices. No tree, no block is going to stand in your way. You are going to feel a sense of victory. And even though your mind can sometimes be confused because you have this sense of fear inside, again, the victory and the success is going to all come into play for you, and you are going to reach your long-term goals. You are planning for those long-term goals. This is having all the money, all the things that you need in your life to bring you all of the abundance that you want. So you're feeling healthier, you're feeling happier, you're feeling more financially abundant. You're planning for your future. You're putting away for your retirement. You might be, you know, planning for travel for your future as well. You know, there could be travel involved here as well. It's like, there's nothing that, you know, your hard work is going to pay off for the long term here. Wow, these are beautiful cards for you, Leo. All right, so now let's get your Making Magic Oracle. Let's find out what your spirit angels and guides, little messages that they would like to share with you as we move through the month of August. There we go. And you got two cards here. So you got number 22, the Philosopher's Stone. It's powerful manifestations of wishes and goals. So again, August 4th, being in your sign, that new moon is a really good and powerful time to manifest all the things that you want in your life, those wishes, those goals, everything, because your goals can be achieved here. We've got the 10 of coins, so you're definitely on the right track there. And then number 5, healing. And there is going to be some healing needed because I think that you've really been feeling like either your mind has been controlling a lot of your thoughts and you're wanting closure from that. You're wanting healing from that. If there's been toxic relationships around you and you've been trying to figure out how to put closure to it, I believe that this healing energy is coming here to help you with that as well. Fives are about change. So there is going to be some changes, and this is what's going to bring you towards that victory and success, more positive movement forward. True healing of the mind, body, and soul. And that is your 4 of Swords and the rest and rejuvenate, that healing period where you are really allowing some time out to give yourself a little bit more self-love. Very important to do that as well. So now let's also get your career and life oracle deck. This will just give us a little bit more information about career, money, and finance. So let's find out, Leo, for the month of August. Let's find out. Anything you'd like to share with us, spirit angels, guides, for the beautiful sign Leo? What are the specifics, some specific messages that you would like to share? There we go. Interesting. And your pre-shuffle education came up. So, you know, some of you could really be looking for more education as well. Let's start with that card. You may need to take a class or do research to find a better position, or you may find yourself writing a book or teaching others. Interesting. Again, it's like you're taking on a whole new chapter here. Again, you know, I think a lot of you might be looking at a certificate or, again, improving your skills to really master what it is you're doing. It's going to open up a lot more prosperity for you as well. And I think it's going to be done with connections. So you're building bridges between people. Contact those who can help you. Your actions set you up for the next opportunity. So again, you're making new connections. You're making sure that you are contacting people that can be helpful. And I think that you are looking at educating yourself. And even if it's not going back to school, for some of you, it might be. But for others of you, it can be online courses just to kind of perfect what it is that you're already doing. Or maybe you're deciding to go in a whole new direction. Now, this is interesting because this authority card reminds me very much of this temperance. And it could be, this could be where there's a little bit of a snag here. Clashes with a boss or a challenge with your willpower. They compel you to respond. So you're going to feel compelled to respond to somebody who you're clashing maybe with. And it could be a boss, or it could be a partner. It could be somebody that, you know, is trying to give you advice, and maybe you feel they're just taking over the situation too much. So choose peaceful situations if you can. So the best resolution here is to choose this peaceful situations. And then you got ups and downs. So your work has potential for both advancement and stagnation. See if there's hope, but allow yourself to move on if needed. So you could see some changes coming into play. And again, with this decisions, you know, with this Two of Wands, you know, there are decisions. You've got the world sort of in the palm of your hand, and you've kind of got this tree that's blocking you from deciding whether you go right or whether you go left. But I believe that you are working, you're going to work out those sort of, you know, conflicts. And I believe that you are going to see that, you know, maybe even with a little bit of education, that you are going to find more advancement. And again, if it's not where you currently are, there's going to be changes happening. Your universe is starting to, you know, the chapters, there's certain chapters that are closing, and then victory and success is coming into play for you. All right, so let's get your fortune oracle. Let's find out what your fortune oracle is. From your spirit and angels, what they would like to share with you. Excellent. So this is going to be, this will be an interesting month for reflection, but I think by the end of it, you're going to feel that 10 of coins, where you're really going to feel like you're, you know, moving along towards building your financial freedom, really. So number 32, transformation. So reach out for the power and strength to make changes, enrich your life, and become the person you want to be. Absolutely. I think that you're going to do that through connections. I think that, that even though there's sometimes there might be a few ups and downs, ultimately victory here is definitely coming into play for you. You've got two victory cards, remember. All right, so you have to reach out, right? Transformations are coming into play for you. And then number 24, patience. So slow down, change your attitude, and clear your mind. And you have to clear your mind, because that Eight of Swords is what, you know, is that little bit of confusion. It's that fear. It's the fear, because our mind can, again, our mind can, is very powerful. So our mind can prevent us from taking risks and taking chances. So slow down, because Mercury retrograde, it's a great time to do that slow down. Change your attitude, be more positive. And by clearing your mind, you're getting the rest, you're rejuvenating all of your inner resources, and you're going to see a lot of abundance. Beautiful. So let's close out your reading, Leo, with your angel number. Let's find out what that is. Okay, they wanted those two to come out. I'm going to read them both. We're going to start with the first one, 999. All right. You need to release. Well, absolutely. We know that. There's changes and transformations are taking place. So balance, finances, success, wealth, cycles, what goes around comes around. Okay. So it says your current circumstances are ending, so you might take advantage of better ones. If you are experiencing a significant change or conclusion, viewing your life as a series of cycles or chapters may be helpful. How can you make room for something new to emerge? So ask yourself that. You need to release something. 999. Good time to release that, of course. Maybe around that new moon on August 4th, around which is in your sign. You know, release so that you can restart. And look at that. You also got 777. You've got good luck. Contentment, prosperity, abundance, spiritual awakening, and divine intervention. This message is most likely to reach you during intense uncertainty. You'll come out winning from everything that may come your way. It's also a sign that you might have much life experience and wisdom to share, yet you'll need enthusiasm and effort to get this message to others. Good luck is on your side here. So, time to release. I'll accept the transformations that are taking place. You may have to have a little bit of patience, but this month is a great time to have patience because of the Mercury retrograde. You're going to see things from a whole new perspective, and you're really going to be able to solidify what it is that, what abundance means to you, and you're going to do a lot of long-term planning, and I believe that you are going to move in the right direction. And for some of you, you could be connecting with new people, gaining some more knowledge, gaining some more education, and you could be finding yourself either advancing in your job or maybe even going in a whole new direction. Lots of victory and success for you, Leo. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope that you found parts of this resonate with you, and if so, please leave comments, because I do love to read them. Please like and share, and until next time, sending you love, light, and positive vibes.